on, guys? It is your boy Seso here with a video here today. Bring you guys finally, you guys can see my face. Also, this is my mic right here. Hey, what is going on, guys? It is your boy Seso here with a video here today. This is actually my normal voice for the record. I just talk a little bit louder for you guys. But yeah, I love you guys so very much. I know I miss you guys seeing me too. Also, little apartment tour will come in kind of soon and like set up video. It's coming soon. It's just like I want it to be kind of perfect. But regardless, you guys click on this video for the starting soon screen animation, all that good stuff. So basically, I'll give you guys a nice cool idea on like a nice idea to create a starting soon screen and an animation screen and like have really cool screen setups, period, right? You get it. But yeah, basically starting off inside Photoshop, moving into After Effects and all that good stuff. Now, one last thing, if you guys did not know, my merch, this Seso HQ RDH merch is now officially out. metathreads.com/SesoHQ is the link. If you guys want to purchase it, it's down below. It'll be the first link. If you guys want to give me a little support and maybe have some little Seso HQ merch, invest in early. Of course, if you didn't get the merch last year, this is your chance now. Yeah, with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you guys are new to the channel, please sure to subscribe. And if you guys like the video at the end of the video, please sure to leave a like on it. And that's all I got. Love you guys. Enjoy the video. All right, guys. So let's make this Photoshop part as simple and easy as possible, starting off with our document size. Of course, under File, New, and Create, I mean, I had to do it. You guys want to go ahead and use 1920 by 1080 pixels at 300 resolution. First thing we are going to do is create a really quick gradient background. So for me, I'm using the hex code 0B0A44 as a nice little purple. Of course, if you don't want to use the same color, obviously, you can use this hex tone, but move your hue bar on the right-hand side to get the same tones that I'll get. Of course, then you guys want to fill in your background with your color. You can, of course, use a brush like I'm going to do, or even quickly fill in with Alt and Backspace to quickly fill in your foreground color. Now, of course, you need to move on to a lighter tone, which happens to be 3B1598. Switch your brush active, you want to lower the brush's opacity in the toolbar above to around 20%. This makes the amount of color, of course, that you're controlling with your gradient a little more easier to work with. Simply then click and hover on the top left until you get a nice desirable gradient. And then you're honestly set for the background. Next, you guys want to set up your current screen's text. So for me, I'm doing the starting soon screen. So for my big text in the background, I'm going to choose to write out the word starting. The font I am using is known as Termina, and the size I also have is around 160. Given that we are at 300 resolution, that's why my size is so big. So if you do have like 72 resolution, this size obviously won't work for you. And for the text color, we actually want to use the first background color that we chose to fill in. That way the text actually plays with the gradient a little bit, as well as also making sure this first text is actually lined up with the left side of the screen. And of course, for the one below it, we want to make a duplicate for it. So you can either Alt and drag or press Control J to make a duplicate. And make sure you guys line this one up on the bottom on the right side of your screen. That way it sort of feels like the word that you're writing out is always in full view if you guys read it together. Now, once you guys are all done, you guys want to write out your name in the same font or a different one, whatever you're floating with that day. However, your text name's color should be a nice complementary color. So something that looks really good with your color that you chose for your background. I chose the color yellow, which is the hex code FFD927. And I also made it around 15 points bigger than the starting soon text in the background. And this is just to add a nice little secondary color for it not to feel too boring. Lastly, in the fonts of your choice. So for me, I'm using the Termina font for the word stream and starting, and the font Stretch Sans for the word soon. Group it, of course, how you see it stacked here, and you're pretty much done. Of course, having the word starting and the word soon being the main focus, and a nice little subtext with the word stream right on the top of the word starting, and you're good. If you guys want to also make a nice little simple square and throw your logo on the left or the right side of this like cool little starting soon grouping, this can also help make it a little more dynamic as well. Of course, now make sure you guys name any of your additional layers that you put in. However, save, and you guys are now ready to move on into After Effects. All right, guys, so let's go ahead and jump into this thing right here, right now, inside After Effects. Of course, I'm gonna go to where it says File, we're gonna choose Import, and we're gonna choose File once again. So, under this is gonna pop up your little file here. You wanna basically find your file that you guys just saved in 2 seconds ago, right? And I'm gonna press Import. Now, over here, this table pops up under Import Kind. This should be changed to Composition, Retain Layer Sizes, and then Layer Options to be Editable Layer Styles. Press OK, all that good stuff. So over here on the Product tab, you want to basically double-click on the one that says Type Composition. Just like this, boom, and you're good. So once you guys double-click, of course, it'll bring up the same exact document sizes, all the layers, all that good stuff, all over here in this composition for you guys ready to go and edit. So the first thing, however, I want you guys to go ahead and do, though, is right-click on the timeline over here, choose Composition Settings, and then change this duration from 20 seconds or whatever you guys have. So I'm gonna put 000 here, I'll put another 000 here, but right here on this third one right here, the third zero, backspace one, and press OK. This will basically make this a 1 second, or 1 minute, excuse me, full like timeline. There you go. So of course, down here below in the bottom left, you guys will see this little zoom out feature. You want to basically zoom out all the way to the left, right? That makes sure you can see everything, highlight everything right over here. and then just simply click and drag and make sure that's all the way at the end of it so that you have no weird like missing layers and things like that. So now we're officially good to go and start this thing. So over here, I have my left-hand side kind of things named, starting background. So these are my two starting backgrounds that are the basically gonna be motion part of this entire thing. So this right here and these two things right here are gonna be the things that are gonna be moving. So for that, all we have to do here is, since I already go ahead and I'm gonna make sure I click it back over here, make sure I kind of layer it right at the end like this. And I'll layer this one over here, right at the end over here. So of course, like I said before in the Photoshop file, these should be lined up on the left-hand side, and this one should be lined up on the right-hand side. That way it kind of still reads starting in its own way, or realistically, it's just to make it look like it's kind of crossing and all that good stuff, right? So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna go ahead and go to the first one, which is the top one right here, right? I'm gonna click on my layer, just like so, and press P on my keyboard to bring up the position keyframe. So with this, I'm gonna basically just click this little stopwatch down here, just like so. And I'm gonna have the first keyframe all set and good to go. So with this keyframe, I'm gonna go all the way to around the middle. So I'm gonna say 30 seconds, right? Just like this. And then basically click and I can either click and hold shift and drag, right? Or if you wanna use this little first tool right here, this is the first one is how you move your X axis. It's what we basically need, right? So I'm gonna move this X axis all the way. So that way my top lines up with the right hand side, just like this. I think that's pretty good, okay? And then I'm gonna do the same exact thing with my other background over here. So I'm gonna go back to the beginning, right? Press P on my keyboard, position keyframe it right here. Then at 30 seconds, right? I'm gonna make sure this one, I wanna hold shift and click and drag. Make sure this is now lined up on the left-hand side. Boom. So now what I can do for us is I can just click on this little first keyframe, press Control C, go back to the end over here, press Control V, and I make sure I just bring this all the way to the end, just like right around here, and that's good to go. We go to click on this one right here is now. Click on this one over here now, excuse me, Control C, and then Control V at the end over here, and then drag it right below where the other one is as well. Make sure it's lined up. I think it is. And basically, now you guys are gonna have this little simple thing where, of course, it starts from here, then they kind of interact with each other, just going down or like kind of crossing, right? And then, of course, then it comes backwards, and we're all good. So, to make this look a little bit more kind of fun or a little more or dynamic, I guess you would say, is we're gonna click on this keyframe, click on this one holding shift. Click again on this one holding shift, or you can click and highlight if you guys can, just like so, right? Right click and then choose, where is it at right here? Right click and choose, oop, I didn't right click the keyframe, excuse me. Right click the keyframe in a second, hold on. All right, right click the keyframe and choose keyframe assistance and use easy ease. This will basically make your little dots, your little keyframes into little hourglasses. So now we can do is over on this left-hand side here, it says graph editor, you wanna click on that. Right, and this will give you a nice little two little lumps, okay, right? So when you guys do that though, we can zoom it out just a little bit. If you guys are not already zoomed out, you can zoom it out over here. Now you just wanna click and hover around these keyframes right here, because what we're gonna do is we're gonna push this one in on the left-hand side, push the right one on the inside as well, push this one on the inside as well, and then push this one on the far right on the inside as well. This will basically make it feel a little bit more dynamic. So if I click it now, it should be a little more quicker at the start, and it should slow down right at the end, and then make a nice little quicker kind of rotation on the other side as well. So basically, we're gonna do the same exact thing with this one over here, where I'm gonna click on all of these, right click, keyframe assistance, on the keyframe, where we go, easy ease, graph editor, highlight these, brings up the nice little anchor points in our little handles here, bring this one in, bring this one in, bring this one in, and bring this one in as well. And just like that, now if we were to render this out, but if we can kind of quickly see it, you gotta see basically it's kind of doing exactly what we needed to do. And of course, since the keyframes are all the same ones at the start and the finish, it'll basically make a perfect clean render when you guys are good to go. Now, keep in mind this, if you guys do wanna do something a little more different or make it just a little more dynamic and just not having this little sort of like text moving in the background, the only moving part. Now you can also do, I'm not entirely sure how to do, we're kind of going on a whim here. However, let's just say at the beginning, right, on the word soon, I can make this word soon kind of like go up and down nice and slowly. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna press P on my position, click a little keyframe just like so. And of course, I want it to start here. Then around 5 or 10 seconds, let's say the 10 second mark, we're gonna have it move a little bit further down. So the second grouping right here, bring this a little bit down, not too far down, just like that. And of course, bring this keyframe again and bring this at the 5 seconds, like right here. And I think it should basically kind of like make it look like it's going up and down. So if I render this out really quick. Here you go, I have it rendered. Now you kind of see if what happens if it kind of goes a little bit slowly down while also the background text is also moving. So you can also make this a little more quicker, of course, if you tighten these keyframes up to be not 10 seconds, maybe 5 seconds. However, it's a nice little simple smooth animation as well. However, it is still very stagnant. If I want to go ahead and click and highlight, of course, once again, all these keyframes, right click, and then keyframe assistance, easy ease. I can do the same as I think I did before, basically pushing this one in, pushing this one in, pushing this one in as well, and then pushing this one in as well, just like that. And now it won't be a static if I were to render it out. And if you guys want to also continue it, so of course this is only doing it for about 20 seconds. I'm gonna highlight the second keyframe and the third keyframe, right? Control C and Control V, Control C to copy. But basically at the 20 second mark, I'm gonna 25 seconds right here. No, let's go to 10 seconds. It's supposed to be 10. Boom, at 30, right? I can press Control V, right? And paste the same exact interaction, do it exactly again at around 40 seconds, right? Then I can go ahead and say, yo, 10 seconds in, 50, boom, keyframe those. And right at the end, it ends up with like a nice little simple 1 second. Well, I'm gonna line this up a little bit different, like right here, around the same thing as the actual ending of the background, starting on the background over here, starting text scrolling in the background. And basically what's gonna happen is the scroll text is gonna happen in the background. The word soon is gonna go nice and up and down. Very subtle, very slow, right? But it's a nice little simple thing you can also add in there. And if you wanna even add even further, why not, right? I'm gonna go ahead and say, yo, the logo over here, right here, right? I'll say it around like 10 seconds in. Let's take the position, okay? Now the position here, it's all good and go. However, we're gonna now with the position here, we wanna click on it, right? And before we actually do anything with the position at all, we're actually gonna click on this little 3D little icon here. This little 3D layer is how you enable 3D. So I'm gonna click over here, click enable 3D. So basically I can now rotate things on X and a Y axis on a 3D scale. So what I can do now is I can say, yo, position will keyframe this, right? I don't know if you gotta position your keyframe as much, but basically we wanna position our, I guess our X value, right? If I were to click this, no, is it Y value? It's Y. Okay, so not the X, but the Y value on a keyframe, just like so, right? And then I'm gonna say, okay, I'm at keyframe right there, right? I'm gonna go around to like, let's say 10 seconds in. So at 10 seconds, it starts, and at 20 seconds, I'm gonna say, yo, click over here. This little 0X whatever, this is basically a rotation you can give it, right? If you look right around here, I'll just zoom in really quick, right? This is the rotation you can give it. However, you can basically give it a nice simple one rotation in. If I just click over here, click, press one, press that, just like so. So now it'll do one full rotation at the second mark right here. So we can make this do not every second. I'll say like, yo, let's just do it like every 20 seconds. So I'll just do that right there. And actually what I'll do is I'll make it do the last one right here. That's nice. So it'll spin once right here. Everything else will be going, right? And then just spin again, just like that, right? Very simple. Oh, I actually made a mistake. This is kind of spinning right here. So what we'll do is before we do that, we want it to go spin, spin, spin. And then over here, wanna say, yo, bring it back over here. Let's say at like 30 seconds, right? So we'll do a nice little full spin, boom, boom, right? Then it'll stop over here and then boom, one more time. And it'll basically restart the entire thing. So it happens again at 10 seconds. It just kind of makes it look, it's always spinning. So it's a nice little fun thing as well we can do. But yeah, I think that's pretty much it. I mean, all these kind of things that are spinning right now could look pretty cool. Now, given the fact this is your starting soon screen, of course, when it comes to your animation for like an intermission screen, what I can do for you guys really quickly, back into Photoshop over here, right? I just make a new layer for ourselves, okay? With this new layer, I can press Alt and Backspace to quick fill in any color. It doesn't really matter. And I'm gonna press Control T to free transform it. Hold Alt on my keyboard, select this icon right here, or excuse me, anchor point right here. Move this a little bit down just like so, just so I have enough space to put some text. Press Enter. Right now over here, I can just basically say, yo, I wanna take all my text that I have here, which is the starting soon screen, all that good stuff. I'll make this a little bit smaller, and I'll have this say, not starting soon screen this time, but I'll have it say intermission. So I'm gonna click this, move this right here. And besides starting soon, we'll say intermission. And I'll change this to being saying like 1 second, like 1 second, like give me a second or be right back or something like that. I'll just do 1 second and then dot, dot, dot. Make this a little bit smaller. And besides stream is starting, I'll do stream is in intermission. Move this to the left hand side. 1 second. And then basically what this can be is your little following kind of part where you can do as well. So basically you can go back into After Effects, right? You can use this screen. I wouldn't make it yellow. This is a little bit too much. I make it like a grayscale, right? And you just put your camera in this. However, you can also put in, of course, besides your animation, you can also change this and put this like to say donator, right? Like you have the word donator be that font. And this font over here, we'll make this font be like top donator, right? Obviously it doesn't have to be this big. Probably this size right here is a pretty good size. Of course, you can have it be top donor, top sub, recent donor, all that kind of stuff down here, right? It's a nice little simple thing. Now, if you want to put this, I want to put this up the top. I'll put this right in the middle, to be fair with you, right here. That made the grouping a little bit better, in my opinion, like the grouping behind it, right? Since this is gonna be moving, right? We can bring this into After Effects now, do the same exact thing, just to the two same starting tune texts, and you're good to go. To be honest, that's what I would do, and this is how I make your simple, clean. English is so difficult. I'm like speaking into this thing, I'm not gonna lie. Do I sound better if I talk like this? Like, hey, what's going on, guys? It's your boy, Seso here. Little tangent, but I'm just having fun with this thing, because I know this is the first time for me seeing you guys listen to it. It's kind of funny. Basically though, yeah, I think the grouping is a little bit better, and this is what I would do for you guys for all your future screens. So of course you have your starting two screen, your animation screen, maybe a be right back screen, but there's no camera at all. So yeah, with that being said, guys, that is the end of the video here today. So I do hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys can now go into Photoshop and After Effects and make your own cool clean animation screens and starting soon screens for you, your friends, or whatever, and just like get involved a little bit. So hopefully you can make it look a little more cleaner, a little more better. And just for the record, color schemes, fonts, all that stuff, change the variety of this here. Of course, you can add some gradients, some grunge, some texture, whatever you guys want to do. Don't be afraid to try it and give it your own, because only thing that's really moving is that little starting soon screen text, or only thing that's moving is your starting text scroll, period. So have fun with it, enjoy it. And with that being said, of course, be sure to leave a like on the video. If you guys are new to the videos, be sure to subscribe. And that's it. Seso HQ out. You're having to keep smiling, stay positive, and stay freaking productive, guys. I love you so very much. And of course, cop the merch if you guys wish to below. Metathreads.com/SesoHQ. And that's it. I love you guys. Enjoy. Peace.